The Clumsies Make a Mess of the Zoo by Sorrel Anderson. Read by Joe Coen. Nervous Exhaustion. It was a Tuesday morning, and everyone in the office was feeling cheerful. Howard was humming a tune and reading a magazine. Purvis and Mickey Thompson were playing a game and eating crisps, and Orchard, the very small elephant, was frolicking, knocking things over.
"Look out, Howard!" shouted Purvis, as Orchard crashed into the coat stand.
"Oof!" said Howard, as the coat stand narrowly missed him.
"That was close," said Mickey Thompson. "It's ever so nice when Mr. Bulletin's away, isn't it, Howard?"
"Yes," said Howard, "ever so."
"How long do you think he'll be gone?" asked Purvis.
"Who can tell?" said Howard. "I heard he's been told by his doctor to have a long rest. He's suffering from nervous exhaustion." Purvis gasped, and Mickey Thompson dropped his bag of crisps.
"Quite," said Howard.
"Are you sure?" asked Purvis.
"I have it on good authority," said Howard.
"Gosh," said Mickey Thompson. "Nervous exhaustion, eh?"
"Bit of a shock, isn't it?" said Howard, flicking through his magazine.
"Yes," chorused the mice.
"I wouldn't have thought it, would you?" said Howard.
"No," chorused the mice.
Howard resumed his humming, and the mice exchanged glances. Mickey Thompson raised an eyebrow at Purvis, and Purvis shrugged. Mickey Thompson prodded Purvis, and Purvis coughed.
Howard, said Purvis.
"Hmm?" said Howard.
"What's nervous exhaustion?"
"Hazard a wild guess," said Howard.
"Feeling nervous?"
hazarded Purvis. "And?" said Howard.
"Exhausted," said Purvis.
"Exactly," said Howard. Mickey Thompson selected a crisp and ate it worriedly.
"So what you're saying," he said, "is he spooked and pooped?"
"If you must," said Howard.
"Poop, poopity, pooped," said Mickey Thompson loudly, and Orchard started trumpeting. "Enough," said Howard. "But it isn't like him," said Purvis. "Mr. Bulletin's normally so bossy," said Mickey Thompson.
"Yes," said Howard.
"And shouty," said Purvis.
"Yes," said Howard.
"And
stompy," said Mickey Thompson.
"Yes," said Howard. "And angry," said Purvis.
Howard thumped the magazine down on the desk.
"And," he said.
"And what, Howard?" asked Purvis.
"And now I can't remember what I wanted to say," said Howard.
"He's getting forgetful," muttered Mickey Thompson to Purvis.
"What?" said Howard.
"It's a symptom," said Mickey Thompson.
"What is?" said Howard.
"Forgetfulness," said Mickey Thompson cheerfully. "You're growing elderly." "What?" shouted Howard. "We were discussing Mr. Bulletin," explained Purvis.
"I know we were," said Howard. "I am well aware of that, thank you very much, and I am not forgetful."
"Of course not, Howard," said Purvis.
"I'm a young man in the prime of life," said Howard.
"Yes, Howard," said Purvis, rummaging for tea bags. "But what do you think caused it? The nervous exhaustion, I mean."
"I don't know," said Howard, "but I expect I shall get the blame as usual."
"Maybe we should make him a get-well card," suggested Mickey Thompson.
"Maybe we shouldn't," said Howard. "I've been given strict instructions to leave him alone in peace and quiet." Purvis handed Howard a cup of tea, and Howard brightened. "And I'll tell you what," he continued, "while Mr. Bulletin's away, I intend to enjoy some peace and quiet of my own." Trumpeted Orchard, crashing into a rubber plant. Said Howard, as the rubber plant narrowly missed him. "What's wrong with Orchard? Why's she hurtling?"
"I'm not sure," said Purvis. "Why are you hurtling, Orchard?"
Orchard tooted and hurtled faster.
"Look out, how..."
"Whoops, too late," said Mickey Thompson, as Orchard smashed into a cupboard and the cupboard landed on Howard.
"Humph,"
said Howard, extricating himself. "What this elephant needs is fresh air and exercise."
"Shall I open the window?" offered Purvis.
"That won't be nearly airy enough for this situation," said Howard, taking a gulp of tea. "I think we'd better take the day off and go out somewhere."
"Hooray!"
cheered Mickey Thompson, bouncing.
"Where shall we go?"
said Purvis, hopping.
"Where? Where?"
"Where do you fancy?" said Howard.
"Seaside?"
suggested Purvis. "Too salty," said Howard.
"Countryside?" suggested Purvis.
"Too muddy," said Howard.
"A woodland walk?" suggested Purvis.
"Too woody," said Howard.
Oh, oh, said Mickey Thompson, waving his hand in the air.
Yes, Mickey Thompson, said Howard.
Crisp factory, shouted Mickey Thompson.
What do you mean, crisp factory, said Howard.
They conduct guided tours and provide free samples. It says so here, said Mickey Thompson, jabbing the back of his crisp packet.
No, said Howard.
But Howard, said Mickey Thompson,
no crisp factories, said Howard. Mickey Thompson sighed and ate another crisp, dejectedly.
I wonder what Orchard would like to do, said Purvis.
Everyone looked at Orchard as she started on another circuit of the room.
It's difficult to tell, said Howard. If only we could speak elephant, said Mickey Thompson. That's it, shouted Purvis, leaping up. I've got it!
He shot under the desk and shot back out again, clutching a green leaflet, decorated all over with pictures of happy-looking animals.
This is where we should go, he said,
flapping it.
The zoo!
Mmm, trumpeted Orchard.
Hooray,
cheered Mickey Thompson.
Too many animals, said Howard.
The mice gasped, and Orchard skidded to a halt.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.